Hey kids, this is Ivan. How you doing? Real quick here, if you're a long-time viewer of my channel, and who wouldn't be? Okay, that's ridiculous hubris, but you might have noticed that I've uploaded a few videos lately which just don't quite fit the normal mode. I don't have my usual greeting, and it might be in profile view rather than in the landscape view, and I might be referring to videos or discussions you have no idea what I'm talking about. So, these are Facebook Live videos that I've downloaded and decided to upload to my channel. And so every once in a while, I'm going to do that. And the history with that is this. You know, I've been involved in a lot of different Facebook groups. And, you know, one of the tools that Facebook, you know, came up with these Facebook Live videos, they've had it for I don't know how long, but Complex Games Apologists kept on kind of evangelizing and say, hey guys, I think we can use this as a really useful communication tool. And despite the fact that a lot of us resisted at first, you know, he pioneered, at least in our group of friends, using these like over and over again, and they seem to have kind of taken off. And people have realized how useful these tools can be to communicate with each other in smaller groups. And so I, you know, I'm a member of several groups where we discuss various topics relating to role-playing, and we can make these little internal videos to each other. And they've proven to be incredibly useful, especially if you've got a group of people and you say, hey, we're going to go play this game. You know, we're going to play Uncharted Worlds, we're going to play Star Wars, we're going to play Star Trek, and you get a little group of people together, or we're going to play several games. And then you can talk about various things in post, but if you need to get more information across, you make a little Facebook Live video. People can comment on it, the whole nine yards. And in the, you know, techniques group I'm involved in, the learning group I'm involved in, we can do the same sort of thing. And what ends up happening every once in a while is, you know, one of these discussions, one of these topics turns out to be really good. And, you know, some of those, especially in the techniques group I've been involved in, have graduated into video ideas that I've then kind of put onto YouTube. Sometimes we've kicked things around and refine it, and then, you know, I throw something up here just to have some kind of record for and to share with you good people. But every once in a while, there's something that, you know, I say something, make a little video, and I realize, well, geez, I really don't want to have to redo that. And I've made some efforts to redo some of those, and, you know, it's no longer spontaneous, it's scripted, and it sucks. And so every once in a while, I decide, let me just go ahead and share those. And actually, what prompted me finally sharing these to YouTube in the first place was that I posted something in one group, I wanted to share it with other groups, I tried to share the link, and apparently, at least unless I'm doing something incredibly wrong, if you record a Facebook Live video in a private or a closed group, if you share it to other groups, you can't change the privacy settings to match that new group. So people that were not members of both groups could not open the link. So, you know, I downloaded the video, and I have to credit Tim Kask with, you know, teaching me that these videos that you make on Facebook Live are downloadable, because if you know who Tim Kask is, great. If you don't, well, Google him. But he made the first curmudgeon in the cellar video on Facebook Live and then actually had a friend teach him how to download that and put it on his YouTube channel. And now, you know, the curmudgeon in the cellar is a regular thing. So I was able to download that. And I decided, okay, well, what am I going to do? Just share it in these two groups? And the particular video, I decided, you know what, I'm just going to upload it as a YouTube video, maybe make it unlisted, and then throw it in those groups. I did that, but I decided, well, why don't I just share it and make it public? So every once in a while, one of these videos is going to, you know, come across your, you know, your screen, and if you're lucky enough to watch it. And so, you know, the unfortunate thing is every once in a while I will be responding to comments that people are making that you simply cannot see because it's a live interactive video every once in a while. And sometimes, you know, I'm going to be referencing discussions that you're simply not going to be able to go back and look at because you're not a member of the group. But, you know, I hope that at least you'll be able to follow along. So, public service announcement. And it's actually really, really cool. If you're not using that, if you're a member of Facebook groups and you're communicating with each other, really pretty useful tool to get a lot of information across at once. And sometimes to actually have interactions with each other. I've done at least one, if not two, Facebook Live chats with Anthony, with Runeslinger, which have been really kind of cool. And one of you ends up in this little teeny box up here, kind of like picture-in-picture, the old TV thing, but kind of a neat little thing. So, yeah, that's my thought for the day. How about that?